Welcome to PhET Interactive Simulations. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to interactive description. Interactive description is text description that is read aloud to the learner, accessed and delivered using screen reader software as the learner interacts with the simulation. This feature provides non-visual access to learners with visual impairments who use screen reader software to navigate and interact with digital resources. To access interactive description, you need to open a PhET simulation that has the interactive description feature while using screen reader software. All screen readers have differences in the way they access and deliver interactive descriptions. We design and test using three screen readers: VoiceOver with the Safari browser on Mac devices, NVDA with the Firefox browser on Windows, and JAWS with the Chrome browser on Windows. Other screen reader and browser combinations may or may not work well. Some simulations with interactive description can be accessed using mobile VoiceOver on iOS devices such as iPads and iPhones. Just look for this mobile accessibility icon. To find all PhET simulations with interactive description on the PhET website, go to the Simulation Filter page. In the sidebar, select Access and Inclusion, and then check the Interactive Description filter. You can also find links to simulations with features still under development on our Accessible Simulations page. These simulations have features that are nearly finalized, but have not yet gone through PhET's full quality assurance process and may have some bugs or need a few changes before being officially published. Now that we know how to find and access interactive description, let me introduce you to how description is structured in any simulation and show a quick demonstration using screen reader software. Then, I'll introduce you to the Alley View, a helpful tool for teachers using interactive description in your instruction. Interactive description conveys information to the learners using two kinds of description: state descriptions and responsive descriptions. I'm going to use the simulation Resistance in a Wire as a demonstration. Keep in mind that what I'll be demonstrating is only a small amount of description available in the simulation to help you understand what to expect from interactive description in any simulation. State descriptions are available at any time for the learner to navigate and read through, just like they would read through a typical web page. State descriptions include a brief summary of what's on screen and information about the current state of objects and controls, all nicely organized with headings, brief paragraphs, and bullet lists. This information updates as the learner interacts and the simulation changes, so the learner can return to the state descriptions at any time, as they need to. Responsive descriptions are read out in direct response to a learner's interactions. They are delivered automatically when the learner navigates to or interacts with interactive objects in the simulation, like buttons, checkboxes, sliders, draggable objects, and so on. Responsive descriptions provide relevant changes to objects and any other part of the simulation that is helpful for the learner to know. Let's check out a very brief demo, keeping in mind that the voice and delivery of information varies per screen reader software and per learner. Here, I'm using the NVDA screen reader software in Firefox on Windows. I have the sim opened and focused. I'll start at the top of the state descriptions and check some of the overview of the sim using NVDA's browse mode.
Resistance in a Wire is an interactive sim. It changes as you play with it. In the play area, you find the resistance equation, R equals rho times L over A, and a piece of wire. Sliders for resistivity, length, and area allow changes to the equation and the piece of wire. The control panel has a button to reset the sim.
Now, let's change something. Listen for the responsive descriptions letting me know what's changed. I'll tab, which leaves browse mode, and focus the resistivity slider. Then, I'll increase it a bit.
Article, list, row, resistivity slider 0.5 ohm centimeters. 0.55 ohm centimeters. As letter row grows, letter R grows. Resistance now 0.733 ohms. 0.65 ohm centimeters. As letter row grows, letter R grows. Resistance now 0.867 ohms.
I'd like to know more about some other parts of the play area. Let's enter browse mode again and navigate by heading to find the wire section of the state descriptions to learn more about the wire in the sim.
Slider controls heading level 3, the wire heading level 3. Currently, wire is of medium length, of medium thickness, and there is a large amount of impurities. In wire, resistance is 0.867 ohms.
Let's change the sim once more by focusing the area slider and decreasing the area.
Resistivity slider 0, L, length slider 10 cent, A, area slider 7.5 centimeters squared. 7 centimeters squared. As letter A shrinks, letter R grows. Resistance 6, 5 centimeters squared. As letter A shrinks, letter R grows. Resistance now 1.30 ohms.
And let's return to browse mode to hear again about the wire and see if anything has changed.
Slider controls heading, the wire heading level 3. Currently, wire is of medium length, thin, and there is a large amount of impurities in wire.
It sounds like the wire has gotten thinner.
Together, state descriptions and responsive descriptions provide the learner with simulation-specific information, providing non-visual access and a rich interactive learning experience with the simulation. The interactive description is not provided visually in the simulation. It's embedded in the simulation and delivered in parallel with the visual simulation using screen reader software. If you would like to see the interactive description, you can use a tool called the Alley View. The Alley View displays a copy of the interactive description embedded in the simulation next to the simulation. A copy of the state descriptions are shown on the right side of the screen, and a copy of the responsive descriptions are shown below the simulation. The Alley View is not intended for student use and will not provide a good experience for learners using screen reader software. The Alley View visually displays all the words we have designed to be delivered by screen reader software. Teachers may find it helpful in determining if the simulation's interactive description meets their instructional needs. You can find the Alley View linked in the teacher tips found on the simulation page. Thanks for watching this video.